friends. I'm so glad that you decided to join us today. I'm so excited to see what about our story, because we're continuing to see the life of Joseph and what God's doing in his life. Joseph is a son of Jacob, and we know Jacob from the line of Abraham. He was Isaac's son, and Isaac was Abraham's son. So we're going to continue to see that God's keeping his covenant with his people and what he's doing, and also just his character and who he is. That goes to our big picture question. Is there anything God cannot do? And we've said that God can do all things according to his character. And we know about his character through his word, through the Bible. And so if you have a Bible nearby you, I would go grab it if you have a chance. Go ask someone if they have a Bible maybe nearby you, look something up about it. But we're going to dive into our scriptures about Genesis 42 through 46 and also chapter 50. So we're going to be summarizing bits and pieces of that, but you can just go ahead and open your word to kind of see where we're talking about and read it later for yourself to really dive into the story. But that's Genesis 42 through 46 and also chapter 50. And we're going to really read about Joseph saved his family. We talked about last week that Pharaoh rose Joseph up. He ended up getting put in prison by Potiphar because his wife shared a lie about something he did not do. And so Pharaoh raised him up because he explained a dream, and he's storing food right now during the 7 years before the famine's about to come, where there's going to be no food. And we knew that Joseph got put in Egypt because his brothers sold him to people who were going to Egypt. And so what they meant for evil, God's continuing to use for our good. And we're seeing God continually work through Joseph, and how Joseph's faithful to God too as well. And so we're going to dive into our story. So get your listening ears on, and we'll go ahead and see more of what's going to happen with Joseph's life. So Jacob and his family were in trouble. Again, we talked about that there was a famine going on. They didn't have enough food to eat, and no one had enough food to eat. So when Jacob learned that there was food in Egypt, he sent 10 of his sons to buy some grain. He kept Benjamin because Joseph and Benjamin came from Rachel, and that Joseph was his favorite son. Remember, he was devastated. We talked about it in our last story, and you can look back at our other stories if you want to catch up, but he was so devastated that he lost Joseph, so he wasn't going to send Benjamin. But he sent his other 10 sons. In Egypt, Joseph was in charge of giving out food, and the brothers came to him and bowed down. Joseph knew who they were, but they did not recognize him. Right there, Joseph standing in front of his brothers, the ones who betrayed him. They're not recognizing him, but he notices them. Joseph remembered his dream of his brothers bowing down to him. These dreams from long before were coming true. Joseph decided to test his brothers. "I think you are spies," Joseph told him. "You are here to spy out the land." But the brothers said, No, we're not spies. We're brothers. There were 12 of us, but our youngest brother is at home, and our father and our other brother is dead." Joseph put his brothers in prison for 3 days. Then he said, "Bring your youngest brother back to me to prove that you are not spies, but one of you must stay here." The brothers went home with food for their families, and one of them stayed in Egypt. They told their father everything that had happened, and their father was very upset. But when all the food was gone, Jacob asked his sons to go back to Egypt. So the brothers returned to Egypt with their brother Benjamin. They took the money to pay for their food, and they took a special gift to Joseph. Joseph invited all of his brothers for a meal. And after the meal, Joseph sent them away with all of his tenants. He cried and told his brothers, "I am Joseph, your brother. You sold me in Egypt. But do not be afraid. God sent me here so I could save your people, a remnant, from the famine." Joseph told his brothers to go home and bring their families back to Egypt, where they would have enough food. Again, Joseph realized that, hey, God knew this was all going to happen, and he brought me here to save our people, to protect us from this famine. Now they have food to be provided for. And on the way to Egypt, God spoke to Jacob in a vision. And he specifically says in Genesis 46, verses 3 through 4, God said, "I am the God of your father. Do not be afraid to go down to Egypt, for I will make you into a great nation there. I will go down with you to Egypt, and I will also bring you back. Joseph will close your eyes when you die." And so he was telling him, Jacob was worried about taking his family to Egypt, but God was reassuring him, "Hey, I'm the God of your father. God of Isaac, remember, who was also the God of Abraham. I've been saying, God, and I told you not to be afraid. I'm going to make you a great nation. God has something in the works, and he's continuing to be faithful, and he's just asking them to trust him and obey him, to listen to him and follow what he says. And so Jacob's family was blessed in Egypt, but Jacob got older and died. Now, Joseph's brothers were afraid Joseph would punish them for what they did to him. They were afraid, okay, now our father's dead. Well, maybe Joseph's going to take out his revenge on us. But listen to this, what he says. In Genesis 50, verses 19 through 21, this is what Joseph says. But Joseph said to them, "Don't be afraid. Am I in the place of God? You planned evil against me, but God planned it for good, to bring about the present results, the survival of many people. Therefore, do not be afraid. I will take care of you and your children." And he comforted them and spoke kindly to them. Joseph knew who he was, and he knew who God was. And he said, "I'm not in the place of God. God had a plan, and he worked it out for the good of people and the good for his glory." And that is the God that they serve, and that's the God that we serve. That he's being faithful to them and continuing to keep his covenant, which is going to continue to carry on all the way up to Jesus. And when Jesus came down to earth to save us from our sins, to die on the cross, and 3 days later rise from the grave so that we could have a relationship with God. The things that seemed so hard, which were so hard to read about, when the things that Jesus suffered for us were all meant to save us from our sins. And what a God we serve, that he did that for us, that he sent his one and only son to die on the cross for us so that we could have eternal life. One that loves us so much more than anyone else could love us here on this earth. And you have an opportunity for that love, an opportunity to receive that love and that gift of Jesus. And you could ask people that you know that know Jesus, to ask them, "What is this gift that I can receive? Can I be in a relationship with a God who does things for the good of people and for his glory? The one who took Joseph and meant something that the brothers were going to hurt him, but then saved people from a famine? I want a relationship with that God." And you can have a relationship with him. To just believe in your heart that Jesus rose from the grave and to confess that he is the Lord. And so I just ask you to ask someone about that and continually dive in. But you guys can read our passages that we talked about more in depth to really see all the truths and who God is and the way he moved in the lives of his people. Our our key passage has been Hosea 13:4, and it says, "I have been the Lord your God ever since the land of Egypt. You know no God but me, and no Savior exists besides me." We're going to see now they're in the land of Egypt, and this is in Hosea's later on in other book in the Bible, referring back to who God is, that I was your God in the land of Egypt, which we're going to see about, and that no Savior exists besides him. And so this is the good things that the Lord has for us today. I just ask that you check out the lesson toolbox where it has questions, the key verse, and really dive more into what God wants to share with you today. We're going to pray, and then I'm going to let you guys go to really read more about that. So let's pray. God, thank you for showing who you are through the life of Joseph, God, and the life of Jacob. God, that you reminded them of who you are, Lord. And God, you are the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac, Father, and the God of Jacob, and you are the God of those who believe in Jesus, Father. And you love us so much, Lord, that you sent your son for us. And we're just so grateful that we get to come before you, Lord, and pray and talk with you because of Jesus, God, that we get to serve you, Lord, that you had a plan in place from the beginning in the book of Genesis to really come and save us, Lord. And I'm just so grateful that you give us the opportunity to share those truths and really listen to the story together, Father. I ask that you be with our friends, that their hearts were open to your word, God, and that your spirit transform them, Lord. Just thank you for this time, and I just ask that your name be glorified in all we do, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.